In this tutorial, we're going to learn about queries in a Microsoft Access database. So in our case here, we have three tables. We have a contacts table. We have the customers table. Then we have also the invoices table. These tables have defined primary keys and foreign keys. And if you want more information on those, you can check the previous tutorial on the importing data and designing the different tables. Now, once those tables have been designed and data has been entered or imported into them, also a relationship was defined, such as customer ID matching with the customer ID in the contacts table, foreign key here. Then we have the contact number going to the contact number from the invoices table. So at this point, we are basically ready to do various different queries or generate customized views of this data any way we basically choose to do this. So there are various ways of creating, a couple ways of creating queries. One of them is by using, so you click on here on create. And under queries, you can use the query wizard or the query design. So first we'll start with the query wizard. You can do the queries on a specific table or on multiple tables as well, if you choose to do so once the tables have been linked together. So let's first do this by using the query wizard. So we click on Query Wizard, then we do Simple Query Wizard, and then click OK. In this case, we'll just ignore this for now, the security warning. And then we're going to use the table customers. Notice we can view the different tables here, all the tables. And then let's say that we want the customer's first name, last name, telephone number, street address, city, zip, and email. Let's say we want this data just for a mail merge or to generate labels or some other use within Microsoft Word or to an email merge and so on. So we can pick all the fields that we desire here. Let's say we don't need the telephone number, just put that back and then click on next. And here's the customer's the title of it, what query. Here you'd make it as meaningful as possible. And then click on finish. So basically it's gonna give us a listing of all the columns here with only the pieces of the data that we requested. If we do not want something, we can right click on this query, we go under design view, and then we can go and uncheck one of those components. Let's say we don't need the email, and then we run this query. Notice the email is no longer showing. Notice when you have this field, if a field shows up here and you put a check mark or you uncheck it, basically, it's actually running the query for that field as well, but it's just not revealing, it's not displaying it. If we wanted to add another field here, let's say the telephone number, we simply double-click on the telephone number and run the query. And notice the telephone number is just instantly displayed. It's also important to understand that all this data, it's not necessarily in this query. All this data is stored in the tables where the query is coming, where we are running the query on. So if you go in the contacts table and you delete something, you need to keep in mind that it's not going to be any longer available in any of your queries or any of the other functions that you do within the database. So at this point, we can close this query and click on OK to save it. Now let's say that we want to also display the contract information. So let's say we want the contract number, the contract amount, then the type, and then the customer information. So what you do here, you can either do this through the wizard, so we can click on Query Wizard, and click OK, and then let's say we go under the contracts, we wanted the contract number, and the amount. That's all that we wanted. Actually, we also want the contract type, and then we want from customers table, we want the first name and last name. Keep in mind here, you can pick here pieces of data from any of the tables that you desire, basically once they've been linked together. Click on next, click on next, give it a name, and click on finish. And notice we have the number, amount, the type, and the first and last name. You could rearrange the order of these by simply going to Design View again, under View here, Design View, and if you wanted the name to be somewhere else, you can just drag it to Design of these fields. Run it. And there it is, the first name or the last name, depending on what order you chose. Close it and save the changes. Now, as you enter data in any of these tables, whenever you run those queries, that data will be reflected in those queries. So now let's say we want a list of all the customers that the amount of the contract it's higher than $25,000, equal or higher than $25,000. So we're going to learn how to specify a criteria for a query. And the way you do that is a couple of different ways. You could either create a new query from scratch, or you can use this existing query. So let's say the contract and customer information, right click on it, choose Design View, and then in here go and specify the criteria. So notice there is an option here for criteria. So what you do is you'd go under the amount here, and then wherever these meet, you put greater than equal 25,000. And then at this point, if we run this, you can always run and test it. Notice these are all the customers that have a contract of 25,000 or higher. So in this case, we could either choose File, save this object as a new one, or we could just save this query and it will be updated with whenever you run it, it's going to give you only those parameters with 25,000 and above. Now what about if we wanted to order this contract by the amount? So then we right click, choose Design View, and then under, let's say we want to order it by and sort it by the amount, so we simply click on the drop down, notice under Sort here, and choose Ascending or Descending. Let's say we want the higher amounts first, then we run it, notice contracts are in descending order. And of course, when you save these, notice you have, actually we don't have that there, but when you save these, you'd give it a meaningful name. So we'll close it, save it, and let it be for now. Here's another way of doing this and creating a query, and we're going to use the query design in this, another method of doing the queries. But in the query design, we're going to get the contract number, the contract amount, the invoice item, the invoice amount, and then we're going to specify we want a listing of only the invoices that have not been paid. So let's go ahead and design this. So we go under Design View, and then we pick the tables that have the data that we need. So in this case, we need the contracts table, and then we need also the invoices table. Then we click Close. Now, the first thing we wanted is the contract number. So we double click on contract number, then we choose the amount, contract amount. Then let's say we want the invoice item. Then let's say we want whether the invoice was paid or not. And of course we want the invoice amount and whether it was paid or not. So we go ahead and run it. And notice we have the contracts, then we have the amounts, the item, and then we have the amounts for each invoice, and then whether it was paid or not. Now let's say we want to display only the invoices that were not paid. What we can do here is we can go under Design View, and then under Invoice Paid for the criteria like we learned earlier, we want the criteria to be no. Notice you can have additional criteria. You could have one thing or another thing. So you can specify more than one criteria, basically. And then we run this. Notice we have only the invoices at this point that have not been paid. Okay, so you could save it, and you could say unpaid invoices. Now you could go back here under Design View. I'm going to make a copy of this actually. Now let's say we wanted to take these unpaid invoices and put in a late fee for them. So what we can do here is, let's say unpaid, basically we're just making a copy of it, of an existing query. We go under Design View. And now we are going to learn how to add an additional fee where we are going to calculate the late fee. So here's how it works. So in this case, we want to add a late fee field to specify how much of the late fee will be. And what we need to do here is we go under a different column, and then we click on Builder. Under Builder, we want to calculate the late fee, so let's say there is a 3% late fee. So you go under the invoice amount, so for each invoice that they are late, we want to add 3%. And we put the asterisk for times 0.03. That will be our value. Then we click OK. Now notice this part here, it says expression 1. Basically we're defining an expression here. However, you can specify instead of EXPR1, you could give it a meaningful name there. So we could say late fee and leave the rest alone. Note what's happening here. Basically it's putting, we are defining a new field. This is a field name. And then the field invoice amount, which is this guy here with brackets, times the value of it. However, I recommend that you use the builder for this purpose. And at this point, if we close this or run it, notice this would be the late fee for the customers. So we have they owed $12,000 in their invoice, and the late fee would be $360. Now, in order for us to add here the dollar signal or symbol here, what we need to do is we can go under View, and then choose Design View, and then we can go under the Property Sheet, and then in here we can specify the format as to what this is. So this is currency. You can specify the decimal places as well. And then we run it again and notice that field that we just created, it doesn't exist anywhere. It's a calculated field. It doesn't exist in any of the tables. It's calculated based on the values from this query. So this is basically how you create a compound or a query using various criteria for it, as well as a calculated field using an expression. Another concept that I'll briefly cover here before we move on to something else beyond queries is that notice in our customers table we have customers from different cities, and let's say we wanted to have only the customers from Lansing and Holland listed, or customers from a specific zip code. So how do we do that? Well, basically what you can do is you can create a query, and so we basically go under query design, choose customers, close, and then let's say we want customers first name, last name, and street address, city, state, zip. Let's say we wanted only the customers from Holland. Just type Holland here under criteria and click on run. And of course it did not run because I put here Holland under state. It needs to be under city. And then we click on run. These are all the customers from Holland. And then if we wanted also the customers from Lansing, we could say we want criteria Holland or Lansing. So those would be both types of customers. So if we run it, notice we have Holland and Lansing. If we wanted to sort them, we just go on under sorting, choose ascending, click on run again, and now they are sorted accordingly. So notice that there is limitless possibilities here as to what you can do once you have all these tables linked, tables populated with data, and then linked together. You can run and look through that information in any way that you'd like with any criterias, and that's where the queries come in. And hopefully this was clear and it's beneficial for you. Next, we're going to move into forms.